about the helping verb and the tenses. How they are related to each other, or how helping verbs help to get to know about the time in which time the sentence is going on, or in which time the sentence we are making, maybe in present or in past or in future. So first of all, we will learn in a short manner about the present, past or future. Now student, present. In present, we used to live. We are living at now in a present age. Whatever the thing happens at now, that is a present tense. Now what things have already happened? About yesterday, about day before yesterday. Yesterday was Tuesday. So that day has gone. So that will be a past. And today, whatever the things we will do today, that will come under present tense. Whatever you will do, whatever you will read, whatever you will write, whatever you watch, that all will come under the present tense. And future. Future means the day which will come tomorrow. We don't know anything about tomorrow. What will happen tomorrow? No one knows what will happen tomorrow. So that is the upcoming day. Tomorrow means Thursday. Whatever will happen, we don't know. We will do this thing, we will be plan for future. That this thing we will do tomorrow, at this time we will attend the live classes, at this time we will do our homework, at this time we will go to play. So about future plannings. So that will come under future tense. So we have these three types of tenses: present, past and future. Now how the helping verbs helps to get to know about the tenses, we will learn in a short manner. So first of all, present tense. So which helping verbs we are using present tense in a short manner? Many are there, but the most common helping verbs are there: is, am, are, has, have. Now students, you know you have too many friends in your classroom. You make the friends in your classroom. So here also we have some friends in a group. Okay, I make two, three groups. First group, second group and third group. So in this first group, we have some friends which will always remain together. Okay, now what is the first group? Is. This is our first group. He, she, it, singular noun. Remember, he, she, it, singular noun. Singular noun means the noun which is only one. Tree, boy, notebook, marker, this is also a noun, this is a singular noun. Duster, this is also a singular noun. I have your book also, this is also singular noun. So he, she, it, singular noun. These four friends always remain in one group. What are the four friends? He, she, it, singular noun. These are the four best friends. They will not lose their friendship in any manner. So they will always remain together. He, she, it, singular noun. So whatever the sentence you will make with this one, we use this helping verb to make in present tense. And when we are using is helping verb, it means we are making a sentence of present tense. Suppose she is writing on a board. She is writing in her notebook. So is coming. So we use is with she or he. He is climbing on the mountain. He is riding a bicycle. Okay. It is walking. It is running. And singular noun, we can take many. Rohan, the name of a person, Ravi, that will also come under singular noun. Rohan is reading a book. So here, see, Rohan is singular noun, that's why is will come. So in this manner, is we use with he, she, it and singular noun. That is our first group of friends. Now we will go further toward the second group. That is alone. No friend is there in that group. That means I is always alone. There is no one in that group. So we use am with I. I am a girl. I am a woman. And I am a boxer. I am a singular one, single one. There is no friend or in second group. Now third group. In third group, too many friends are there. How many are there? 1, 2, 3, and 4. 4 friends are there as we have in first group. Now what are their names? You, we, they, and plural noun. Plural noun means many in number. Okay. As I have 2 notebooks. So these are plural. Okay. I have only 1 marker at now, but if I have 2 markers, then it will become plural noun. So you, we, they, plural noun. This is our third group of friends, and here they will always remain together in this group. So whatever we will use in this group, we will use with all these friends. Now here R. R is the helping verb which we use with this you, we, they, plural noun. Okay students, suppose you are. Yes, today we are going to play basketball. They are watching television. Plural noun. Ravi and Rohan are playing basketball. So in this manner we can use our helping verb with this third group of subject to make the sentences in present tense. Okay students, now come forward towards the now next one is a past tense, the things which had already happened about the yesterday's one. Whatever things have already yesterday, that will come under past tense. So students, here we will use was, were, had, helping verb to make sentence. Now we have the groups same as we have here. He, she, it singular. Here also he, she, it singular. Now students, this group will remain same. Whatever the rules we apply in the tenses, these groups will be in the same manner. How we will learn in this one? Here was is the helping verb in past tense. Whatever sentence we will make with was helping verb, it means we are making a sentence of past tense. He, she, it, singular noun. Okay students, suppose yesterday he was standing. So he was standing yesterday. So here this sentence belongs to past tense because we are talking about the past, about the yesterday which had already gone. It was dancing. She was singing. So here I am using was helping verb to make a sentence of past tense. So when we will use was and were, it means we are making a sentence of past tense. Here verb, we have verb also, were helping verb. Okay. So were we use with you, we, they, plural noun. So students, we have to learn these two group of friends. The first one is I, we. The first one is he, she, it, singular noun. And the second group of friend is we, you, we, they, plural noun. Okay. Now future tense. The things which will happen tomorrow. Whatever we are planning about tomorrow, that will come under future tense. We will use here shall, will. Okay. These are the helping verbs which we will use in future tense to make a sentence. Now will, we will use with I, he, she, it, singular noun. Okay students, and shall with you, we, they, plural noun. So here to make a sentence of future tense, we will use the helping verbs will and shall. Now we have other helping verbs also as can, could, should, may, might. Student, these are also the helping verb with the help of which we can make sentences. So in this manner we have learned about some helping verbs of present, past and future. Now students, we will learn about one more helping verb, two or three helping verbs: do, does and did. Now students, we have more helping verbs of present and past: do, does. That these helping verb we use in present tense. So do and does. also to make a sentence. Now, how we will use this sentence, these helping verbs as sentence? I am explaining you. Listen it carefully, students. Okay. Now we do. We use I, we, you, they. Plural noun means when too many nouns are there. Plural means many in number. That time we use do helping verb to make a sentence of which tense? Present tense. Yes, students. You can see. You can see on the board also written sentence. We do not play. Now we belongs to this group. So that's why I will use do. Do helping verb to make a sentence. Now when we will talk about this does. Does helping verb. We have a ender group of the subject. He, she, it, singular. Singular means only one noun. Now when we make a sentence with the name of a person, okay, that time it belongs to a singular noun, and whatever the rules apply to singular noun, that will also apply to the name of a person. As he, he is singular, means only one noun is there. So here we use does helping verb to make a sentence in present tense. Okay, students. So he does not eat an apple. So here I will write does because I am making a sentence of present tense with he, means singular. Okay, students. So in this manner we use do and does helping verb to make a sentence in present tense. Now past. In past tense we use one more helping verb of verb do, that is did. Did is always in a past form. Do, did, done. These are the verb forms. Do, did, done. So did is already in a past tense. So whenever we will make a sentence with did helping verb, we always write the first form of the verb, means present form of the verb. When we are making a sentence of past tense with did helping verb, that and we will use the verb that will be in a present form, means first form of the verb. I will explain you with the help of example. I have written we did not play. Did is already in a past tense, so here I will not write played. Okay, students. Now one more sentence I have written. He did not write. So here did is already in past tense, so I will not write the second form of the verb